Oh, sorry, excuse me. Hey, Ross World, my money makes money. Don't eat out. Don't. And what I mean is, yes, you're going to eat out sometimes, but I know that a lot of you eat out all the times. 7 days in a week. How many days of the week do you actually eat out? And eating out means this. That, yes, it means Chinese that you order. It means the Domino's, the Pizza Hut, and you gotta go pick up Little Caesars. And it also means those fancy restaurants that you go to, like McDonald's, Burger King's, Popeyes, and Kentucky Fried Chicken. Whatever is your pleasure. But this is the thing, it's very, very expensive. It's very, very costly in so many ways. So it adds up like, well, no, I only spent like $5 or $6. Okay, last time I checked, five times six, and we're talking about 6 days a week because maybe you eat at church on Sunday or maybe you're at a friend's house on Sunday. A lot of people do that. It's $30. It's $30 that you could have invested in any of all these platforms, okay? Whether it be Wealthfront with accumulation up to $100, we know that it takes at least $100, but Stash, Acorns, and buying stocks on Robinhood. The links are in the description. If you are eating out majority of the week, not only are you losing and wasting majority of your income, majority of your money, you are also killing your body, okay? No, this is not a nutrition video, but I want you to think how money and food are so related. Because if you eat out all the time, MSG, salt, you don't know what they're actually putting in your food. You are spending so much money and then you are eating so unhealthy, which contributes to you being very, very unhealthy, which over time contributes you to what? Going to the clinic, going to the hospital. Oh, I have high cholesterol. Oh, I have gout. I'm in the early stages of diabetes. I develop insulin resistance. Whatever it is. But this is the thing. If you eat in, you can also eat unhealthy too. I know somebody was going there. You can also eat unhealthy too, but it's your choice. You can go out and you say, well, eating healthy is very, very expensive. But I promise you, eating out is even more expensive. Know how to do things. Now, I go to Walmart, and I know some of you are going to rag on Walmart like not the best place where you should get it. But nevertheless, I go to Walmart and I buy me a big old bag of kale, right? Fresh, organic, whatever. And then I freeze it. Then I freeze because a lot of us, we like, oh man, every time I buy fresh food, it goes bad. Freeze your spinach, freeze your kale like I do, and it lasts a very, very long time. You set out for a couple of minutes, you take some little bit of oil, maybe some little smoked sea salt or Himalayan salt, very little, and you simmer it, and it's very, very delicious. It goes with some meat or potatoes or rice, however you want to do it, okay? But you know exactly what you're putting in your food because when you go out to eat, there's so many associated costs because we're in this mindset as people around the world, and I'm just going to rag on Americans because that's what I am. We eat a three-course meal most of the time. Now, some of you may cut out dessert because you had a big meal, but most of us get there. We want a drink. Yeah, man, I had a long day. I want a drink. Then we get an appetizer. Okay, we get an appetizer, and then we order the main course. And they like, oh, sir, would you like dessert? Nah, I really don't like dessert. Let me look at your menu. Oh, you guys got apple turnover cake or whatever it is, red velvet, whatever you like. They have it, right? So you're like, yeah, I try this. And you say, well, some of you say, well, I take some of that, and then that's an extra meal. Listen, I promise you see all these YouTube channels about nutrition, and they meal prep every weekend or Sunday, Saturday, or Monday, whatever. And that meal lasts them throughout the whole week. That's a great idea. And I know some of you are like, no, I'm not gonna meal prep. I'm not gonna eat the same thing every day for lunch for a whole week. I'm not gonna do it. Because I know most people that do brown rice, broccoli, and chicken, okay? But this is the thing. How about this? You meal prep, and when you meal prep, you make two of the same meals. So you eat it only 2 days. You maybe eat it on Monday and eat it on Wednesday, and then you do two or three types of meal preps. So you are actually changing up your routine of what you're eating. You're not eating the same thing every day. This is, I'm just trying to get the ideas running. I don't have the answer, okay? I only have options and ideas to give you because it's all related to what? Saving money. Getting out of debt, saving money. Because when you eat out, you had to spend money to go drive to the place to sit down and eat. Or you say, oh, I get delivery. Then you give the delivery guy a tip. Or, and then when you're at the restaurant, you give them a tip. Somebody said, well, I don't really tip. Because it doesn't matter. We know what the usual person does. You get in your car with your loved one, with a friend, by yourself. You go to that restaurant. We either be through the drive-thru or you sit down and you eat and you leave a tip. And some of you do an appetizer, main course, and dessert. Then some of you say, well, I just do a main course. But nevertheless, you're spending your hard-working money and you can be saving it. If it's $5 you can save a week, that's $5 that you saved in a week. Stop spending your money going out to eat. And no, I'm not saying stop totally going out to eat. I'm saying stop the frequency, stop the intensity, slow it down. Go out once every 2 weeks. Go out once every month. Go out once every quarter. Treat yourself to something really nice. Don't go get a steak from Black Angus. Go get a steak from Ruth Chris. Go to one of those really nice sit-down places where you're going to spend $100 for a steak, like El Gacho's, if you had that on your side of the coast. Or Razor Classic like you have in Maryland that I spent too much money in there. Woo! I spent about $300-$400. That was a lot of years ago before I was on my, you know, financial tip, guys. I did not know them damn steaks was that much, but it was so good. It melted in my mouth like butter. If you ever had a good steak, never mind. I'm off of it. But if you're going to eat out, save it for something special. You know that you have a friend or a family member's birthday that you're going to go out and you're going to spend money. Save it for them. Don't eat out. If you don't know how to cook, you have so many different venues, different places, websites. You know, you got YouTube, Pinterest. Everybody's giving you advice. Everybody's giving you options of recipes, how to cook it, what you should do after you cook it, how you eat it, etc., blah, blah, blah. So this is Ross World, where we're going to start eating in more because we understand not only when we eat out, we're wasting our money, but when we eat out, we become even more unhealthier than we were before. I'm out.